This is a lot to process. Shannon, would this work?
No. Absolutely not. Skip, it sounds good on paper. Oh, man, James Harden, Kyrie, KD. But Skip, you got three guys that have three of the 16 highest usage since the merger. Mm-hmm. Now, last year, James Harden, before last year, before he paired with Russ, he was either first or second in usage. Last year, he was third. He dropped all the way down to third. Kyrie is a guy that needs the ball. Now, KD needs the ball, but not nearly enough, and not nearly as much as these other two
guys.
Skip, now, at some point in time, we're going to have to come to the conclusion. It's not everybody else's fault that plays with James Harden. Dwight Howard, he couldn't make it. Chris Paul, he couldn't make it. Russ, he couldn't make it. At some point in time, the common denominator is still James Harden. Kyrie's complaining about the ball with LeBron. LeBron is way more of a willing passer of the basketball than James Harden. And now you're going to put all three of these guys together, Skip, and you're going to give up Dinwiddie, LeVert, Jared Allen. I would no way do this. And that means no way. It's not going to work, Skip. It sounds good in theory. But James Harden and KD need to understand they're very different players than when they were, 8, 9, 10 years ago when they were together, Skip. James Harden is a different animal. He doesn't see himself as the third best player on a team.
He does not.
Kevin Durant is a different animal. He doesn't see himself as just a guy on the come. It ain't working. You know it's not going to work. It sounds good. You just wanted to get together so you think they could take down my guy. But my guy is an emperor.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's an aging emperor.
Don't do that, Skip. Don't do that.
Okay, so my first question is this. Kyrie and KD are childlike to me. They're like besties, but they're like, I'll give them like college-like. Let's do that.
Yes.
And it's like, hey, we saw that video of them up in the hallway up at the All-Star game.
Right.
We could get two maxes under the cap in Brooklyn.
Right.
And KD was like, you want to go to Brooklyn? Well, everybody thought they would go to revive the Knicks, put the Knicks back on the national map. It'd be a great move. It'd be a legacy move for both of them. No, Kyrie decides, I want to go to Brooklyn. Okay, I'll go to Brooklyn with you.
Yeah.
And KD seemed to put no real thought into it except Kyrie wants to go there, so I'm there too.
Right.
Okay, what I don't know last night, and we won't know, did KD inform Kyrie that he was recruiting James to force a trade to the Brooklyn Nets?
Right.
Did Kyrie, was he in the loop of that? Because if he is, then okay, at least it's got some kind of chance. But if he's not, it could be chaotic disaster.
Right.
Because to your point, listen, Kyrie and James, I couldn't pick two worse fits of those two. Because Kyrie is his own man, we know that. And he wants to have control of the game and the ball, which is why he and Kevin are a great fit together because they love each other. I think they will willingly sacrifice for each other.
We thought James and Russ loved each other.
Well, they did. They sacrificed for each other as much as they would for any other human, and it still didn't work.
Right.
Okay, because to your point, James fell one notch in usage rate because he said, okay, I'll let you have the ball some. And you drive it right-handed, and I'll drive it left-handed. And there were nights it was really it was fun to watch, and it worked. But in the end, Russ said, I can't live with this anymore. Right. And then James, and I pity James here because he's saying, wait a second, I'm going to be left all alone in Houston. What's going to happen to me?
You should have thought about that before you started.
Okay.
The way you play, Skip.
Okay, I got it. But he's saying, if he wants out, then I got to get out because I don't want to be here solo act. So maybe I should go to Brooklyn. Hey, guys, how about having me in Brooklyn? Won't it be fun, the three of us, me and Kevin, reunited from our days in OKC when James is coming off the bench?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Averaging 15, 16 points a game as opposed to a guy that's averaging over the last couple of years probably, 36 one year, 34 last year, 30. No, Skip. This is James Harden's fault because Daryl Morey did everything he possibly could. He built this entire team around James Harden.
He did.
And now nobody wants to play with James Harden. He's like, well, I want out too now.
Okay.
No, hold on. You done made me cook all this food. You going to eat it. It's like when you ask your grandma, your parents to cook you something.
I got
you
it.
You know, like, I don't want it.
Yep.
Oh, you going to eat this.
Okay.
Man, if I'm Tim or Fertitta, you ain't going nowhere, bro.
So how could I endorse this trade? I already picked the Nets to win the East next year with Caris LeVert and Dinwiddie and Jared Allen.
Right.
Well, I don't want to have to trade all three and probably more for James Harden.
Yes.
Why would I do that and get left with a big three with the Nets it'll be chaotic disaster. You know it, and I know it.
And then you got all three on max contracts. Mm-hmm. Good luck filling in the rest of the At least Rob Pelinka could fill in spots because LeBron was on the max and AD was almost near max. But you could fill in. When you got three guys on the max, Skip, mm-hmm. okay, where the rest of the money coming from? What you going to fill in?
Okay, so I loved it that you have an up-and-coming LeVert.
Yes.
He can score it. And I love it that Dinwiddie is becoming like a veteran scorer.
Right.
Well, you can blend them with Kyrie KD and figure it out and let Jared Allen, can he protect the rim?
Exactly, yes.
Okay, now you have what's called a basketball team.
Right.
The other way, you got a mess. You got the biggest soap opera that they would have all the back page headlines in New York, but at what expense?
For an all-star game, Skip, this would be fun to watch. KD, Kyrie, and James Harden on the all-star team, that sounds good. But a real basketball game where they're not going to just let you get up and down. Okay, just let them get up and down. Nobody playing no defense. I just don't see how this works, Skip. Mm-hmm. For James Harden to need the ball and to have the ball as much as he does, for Kyrie to need and to have the ball, mm-hmm. KD is the one that needs the ball the least, but he still wants the ball.
Yeah, when I heard this, I thought, well, is Kevin thinking about semi-retiring? Because he'd have to say, I'll just go along for the ride.
But Skip, remember, he wanted out of OKC because the guy dominated the basketball. So now you're going to play.
It's more about decision-making than dominating.
Well, Skip, if you don't dominate the ball, you're going to make the right decision. I just don't see it. If it happens, I want to see it. Just like I said, I didn't believe Russ and Harden was going to work. Friendship is all that aside. That's fine. I got a lot of friends. Don't mean I want to work and play with them.
Well, unless Brooklyn could get a new rule passed that you get to play with two basketballs, maybe. I don't know. Two would work.
But Kyrie and James, Skip, that doesn't go together.
No, it does not.
Because neither one of them play off the ball. Did you see what James Harden did off the ball when Russ had it? Go stand in the corner.
Kyrie can't be very happy this morning.
Okay, it feels good on paper. You guys have convinced me. It felt really good, but it might be too much. Okay, thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show, and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed, or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.